Hello?
Hello, Mr. Rhodes. My name is Roy Millard. I work for the Wellsmith Police Department as a homicide detective. According to our records, you are the sole inheritor of the Rhodes Mansion, which is located in the town of St. Rhodes. Have you completed the takeover of the property?
This is news to me. I hadn't been informed about inheriting any property.
I see. The problem is, we've discovered a connection between your house and a previous case I investigated almost 10 years ago. I need you to come to the Wellsmith Police Station to provide some information and grant authorization to search the building. When you arrive, you can also sign some legal paperwork to formalize your ownership of the property.
Sure, I can do that. But I'd like to view the property first.
Okay then. I'll be on my way to the town right now. Let us meet at the mansion entrance.
All right, Detective. I'll be there in a few hours.
Okay. See you then.
Had to take the scenic route thanks to that damned road work.
I need to look for shelter from the rain before I catch cold.
Anyone home?
Guess not. Candles. Candles are lit. Maybe Officer Millard was here. Door seems to be the only way to the other part of the town.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
are so many missing posters with dates on them. There might be a connection between these and the massacre of 1943. I should find another way. Just the thought of what might have happened here gives me the chills. Just the thought of what might have happened here gives me the chills. I need to remove the cover before I can check inside the well.
need something strong to remove it. The spare key must be around somewhere. Old habits die hard. Locked.
blocked. I can see cables connecting to the door. Looks like it's electrically locked for some reason. Blocked. Blocked. The fuse box is missing a lever. In order to operate it, I need to find it first. Thank you. guess that's the lever that operates the fuse box. Who in their right mind would put it there? There must be a way to get it somehow. It's moving, but not enough. I can grab it now. Fuse box is missing a lever. In order to operate it, I need to find it first. Looks like I managed to turn the power on. Now I can try opening the electrically locked doors.
Finally reached you.
Detective Millard, is that you? This is George speaking. George Rhodes.
Oh, hey George. It's a surprise to see you show up so early. I got held up on the road due to the weather. By the way, did you run into my partner on your way there?
No, I didn't see anybody around.
I suspect he's been delayed, just like me. But fear not. I'll make my way over there in no time.
All right. See ya. blocked. Indents on both the ring fingers, and they're worn around the edges. Thank you.
What the?
Something is obstructing the keyhole. I guess I'll have to remove this rusty lock by force.
Something is obstructing the keyhole. I guess I'll have to remove this rusty lock by force.
It broke. To be expected from such an old side cutter. Locked. Locked. Thank you.
should find another way. flashlight's not working in here. It's like the light is being swallowed up by the shadows.
Thank you. Where did he go?
It's all covered in blood. think it's released itself now.
tell me, isn't there something really strange going on around town since your arrival?
What do you mean exactly? I thought I was going crazy.
I need to ensure we're on the same page. I don't know how to explain this, but it seems to me like we're trapped in a fleeting vision.
A vision?
I feel like we're both caught up in a twisted mess of confusion and fear. I've heard the whispers, the tales passed down from generation to generation. My father used to tell me these stories, but I never believed him. Until now. Let's meet face to face at the post office, and I'll clear things up for you.
Sounds good to me. I'm on my way.
Something off about Detective Miller. Assuming he even is a cop. Don't let your guard down, George.
Thank you. concerns about me. Of course, I'm not the person you call Roy. It's high time for a proper greeting. In your tongue, I am called Beleth. But my nature, you cannot grasp. It's enough to simply say that I am a benevolent spirit. That's all for the chit-chat. There is a document here on the table. It holds detailed instructions about how to get rid of your troubles. Take it and go to Rhodes' house. By the way, you need to run. Something wicked is coming your way.
I knew it. He's been deceiving me all along.
He's definitely not who he says he is. And he's hiding something from me, I can tell. But what? I've got to get to the bottom of this.
It's all covered in blood. It's all covered in blood.
Thank you.
one-way ticket to God knows where. Now we're good, that's for sure.
Somewhat unusual plays at the Wellsmith Public Theater. I wouldn't have bothered watching the actors stare at performances if it was not for her brilliance.
This isn't me. It's someone else. A more tortured mind.
Like there's something missing from this board. I should try to find it. It looks like there's something missing from this board. I should try to find it. Looks like there's something missing from this board. I should try to find it.
Blocked.
Thank you.
The place she was so fond of is called the Bothan Grace. She believes this plane led me to her like moths to a flame. Let me tell you what happened. There was a demon who yearned to experience the physical delights of the material world, and covertly visited the world of the living, where he met a lovely woman named Lily. Together, they had a child. They named Lucius, and they wanted him to be wise. But he was not your typical child. He was cold, complacent, and indifferent. Thank you. same mundane manner as it does to mortals. But the demon, as he was not born of flesh and blood, but flames, slowly got tired of life's dull and tedious pace. So his thoughts turned sinister and astray, and his true nature keenly took over. Thus, after a subdued infancy, he realized his fate. God had turned him human, and he and his descendants after him were sentenced to mortality. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eventually, Lily started to realize the disturbing changes in the body and soul of her lover, and gradually turned afraid of the cold shimmer in the eyes she used to love. The demon realized that he had lost control over his son and wife. To revert the damage, he resorted to dark magic, unknown to mankind.
need to find an object that fits this opening. It's not ready yet. Something's missing.
And hast thou slain the Jabberwock? Come to my arms, my beamish boy. O frabjous day, Calloo, Calai, he chortled in his joy. When Lily regained consciousness, she saw the sufferings of the madness she had inflicted on her beloved, and her mind departed from her body for good, condemning what was left to eternally walk the house, where they had shared the most precious of memories, alone.
You've done well, rescuing your grandmother from the grip of darkness that held her captive. But the journey is not over yet. The next step is the house of your father's dearest friend. You will delve deep into the darkness caused by your kin and their brethren. Now, off you go. Thank you. first guardian, your grandmother Elizabeth. But your labor is far from over. The other guardians still stand in your way. Countless people were sacrificed here, and they now belong to the shadows. They are slaves to the old ones, just like you will be if you fail. It's time to put an end to all of this.
This is beyond outrageous. He's taking me for a ride.
this sigil spot is somehow connected to that locked door. Blocked. Just the thought of what might have happened here gives me the chills. Just the thought of what might have happened here gives me the chills.
This maze will guide you deeper into the church, where Visago has been revived. These halls are haunted by an ominous presence, a fierce guardian of the demon Basago. Be cautious and use your magical sigils to protect yourself from this terrible monstrosity.
Presumably, I have to infuse these strange objects with demonic energy to activate them. Looks like this spot was designated for the drawing of magical sigils to ward off evil. Thank you. The gate won't open until I find the missing component to this demonic device.
The presence of the demon Visago looms ever closer. A long-standing foe of your ancestor, Samyaza. You will come across a device created by your ancestors. Scatter the remains of the heinous sisters and Elizabeth into the two pits. Then wield your demonic weapon. Break the crystals that are protecting it, and deliver the final blow to Visago. It's the only way to end this never-ending nightmare.
some force is shielding it from getting damaged. What I am certain of is this place will never see me again.
Thank you.
my complete and boundless form. You, wretched human, have served your purpose. Your time has come to an end.
It is nice to see you here, my grandson.
Yes, welcome to your eternal resting place, George. Make yourself comfortable, if you can.